Hey, I'm Kyle Reedstrom. We are Passive 25K Group, and this is our boot camp to help you get passive income in your world in 2022. We've got 15 exercises for your success. Let's check them out. You might be one of those people that has a stable job, a nice source of income, W-2 income, but you're curious about another income stream, maybe a passive income stream. Maybe you know somebody that has passive income stream and you're curious about that, but you don't know where to start yet. This video and this tool can be something to get momentum going for you to start your passive income journey. Exercise number one, self-awareness test. This is simple, but very important for you to know what you do have, what you don't have, what you're good at, and what you can work on. Some things you might have in your corner is time, energy, interest, curiosity. Some things you might not have that you see other passive income investors have is resources, financial backing, deal flow. These are things that come later. You gotta start the process. Exercise number two, creating your passive income statement. This is a statement you're gonna come back to time and time again. For my wife and I, our passive income goal is $25,000 a month. This is enough for us to make what we wanna make, give what we wanna give, save what we wanna save, go on vacations we wanna go on, and continue to invest. This statement is something we come back to as our main vision, and we build out from there every year. So this is a crucial time for you to write down your passive income statement on what you want to accomplish. Exercise three is prep your battle plan. Your battle plan is what you're about to do, and this gets into some of the specifics. What's your passive income number per month? What date do you want to get it by? The important one here is who will be affected by this goal? Obviously you, but who in your family, future generations, the implications that this has for you to act on this? What is the consequence of you not doing this, AKA your status quo? If you continue on your path, what is your outlook? How does this change it? And if you don't do it, what happens? That can be a massive question that can help you on your journey. And what is the next step? We call that the lead domino. The first thing you need to knock over in order to make the next things easier. Exercise number four, check up on your checkbook. If we're gonna make big financial decisions, we gotta know where you're at currently. Okay, so this is just a quick checkup on how much monthly income's coming in, what's your monthly expenses, maybe break it down to house, car, food, entertainment. What are some of those balances, things that you need to get rid of to in order to create more margin in your monthly income? Of course, passive income is one of those things, but in order for us to save and really create systems around getting passive income, you gotta know your numbers first. Exercise number five, your human resources list. And this isn't human resources like you think they are. It is going to be crucial that you have people in your world, your team, in order for you to succeed in passive income. Nobody's done this alone. It always comes with massive help from qualified experts in their specific fields. Things like accountants, lenders, inspectors, real estate professionals, vendors that can work on the properties that you might have in the future. These parties are crucial, and I want you to know who you already have relationships with and who you might need to form relationships with. This is your checklist. Take inventory of who you have on your human resources list. Exercise number six, start stealing from yourself. This is our proven saving system that has worked time and time again to help people create passive income. Savings is boring, but this is a small step for you to create little incremental savings and put them into one place for you to build a massive pool for you to pour into passive income investing. So here's a couple recommended apps that we love that take little bits in different ways. And then at the end of each month, we like to pool all of our totals together and see how much we've saved. This will get you to your savings rate, which is crucially important for you to eventually understand. And once you know your savings rate, you can start to project out when you'll have enough to start investing in passive income. Passive income investing only starts with savings. And as boring as that sounds, you need to get started in that. So this is your tool to start down that path. Number seven, now we're getting into scalability and we're gonna configure your business for growth. There's a couple of check boxes you need to do if you're gonna start getting into the passive income world. Now you might have your savings systems set up, you're stacking money every month over here, getting ready, now you need to get prepped. So things like getting your LLC set up, talking to your commercial banker, getting that approval letter. What's your savings systems? Are you adding more to that now that you've got some momentum? Do you have your real estate deal finder or your real estate mentor? Also, do you have your tracking systems proactively set up for once you've already found your passive income property? Also, do you have those vendors that you're starting to get lined up for the different parts of getting a passive income asset? These are crucial things for you to start checking off. Once you have these things set up, your business now can scale, duplicate, and grow. Exercise number 8 is all about knowing your real estate overview. Okay, so in order to acquire a passive income asset or rental property, it's gonna take about 20 to 45, maybe even 60 days of time for that acquisition process. So we did all this work to prep. Now after you get your approval, you might be analyzing property, going and looking at property, and eventually offering on a property. Boom, acceptance. Now we're gonna move into what I think is the most important part, which is inspection period. This is the time for you to perform your due diligence to make sure this is the asset you wanna buy. After you pass through inspection period and you know what you're getting into, now we're gonna look to get a bank appraisal, make sure the value's good, and then we're just gonna prep for closing. After that 45-ish days, you're gonna go sign on the line and you have your first passive income asset. Exercise number 9, what does your next 90 days look like? Some of you might be watching this at the beginning of the year, and this is your year to capitalize on your passive income goals. We now have it laid out in the next 12 weeks. What do you want to get done? Maybe you want to take some time, a week, two, three, to prep, analyze, do some of these steps. But eventually you have to get past that point and start hunting down properties, running numbers, getting familiar with what properties are out there, what's good, what's bad. Then you got to take action. You have to offer on properties. Not every property is going to be perfect. But offering on a property, this allows you to project when you want to be starting to offer on properties. And then the last step is closing and stabilizing a property, which takes some time. You might be closing week 8, and it might take a couple weeks to stabilize things or work with your property manager on getting that asset ready to rock. This is a good way to lay out the groundwork for what your next 12 weeks look like, so you spend time prepping, but also spend time acting. Exercise number 10, define your financial freedom equation. This is my favorite equation. This equation stands the test of time. We read this in a book somewhere, and this is where our eyes lit up. Guys, this is coming back to why we're doing this. You know your expenses from our checkbook checkup. Now you're starting to get passive income into your world. And once your passive income surpasses your expenses, you know what that means, financial freedom. That's the goal. You might have this equation in your passive income statement. This is a time for you to review what your financial freedom equation looks like. Exercise number 11, connect with the experts. If I told you you were gonna do this passive income journey alone, I'd be completely lying to you. It's going to take a family, a team, experts in the field that have gone before you for you to have success at this. And you need to know them. You need to form a relationship with them. They are not your competitors. Every expert or mentor I've had in my life has greatly reduce the time towards my financial freedom goals. And I think you can do the same. And so this is a list for you to list the 5 people, write down 5 people that are where you might want to be, and then how you can build a relationship with them and how you can be beneficial to them. We don't always want to go to people like that asking for things. We have energy, time, we have things we can provide them. Be creative with how you put value into their life. Exercise number 12, explore the 5 passive income heroes. Now there might be more than 5, but we like to focus on 5 streams of passive income. And real estate's one we love. This is one that's tried and true. Definitely want that in your portfolio. But there's others too. High volume savings and investing. Letting your money make you money, literally. The stock market. These are companies that you have an opportunity to buy stock, buy equity and ownership in that are gonna pay you back as they succeed. We like to buy stocks that we enjoy, that we use, that we believe in, and we like to buy them consistently. We're not trying to play the market because we're not experts in that, but we're gonna try to buy companies we consistently enjoy over time in order to gain returns from those companies. Affiliate and network marketing, these might be opportunities in the internet age that we can use, create passive income, and it's kind of a set it and forget it, truly passive income. And then business equity and systems. These are businesses you might set up to solve problems, people you can put in place, and then you can just be in ownership, or maybe you get an opportunity to invest into a business or a system where you can sit in the owner seat and just collect returns as it grows. Exercise 13, set a launch date. This is a perfect thing for you to do to hold you accountable. It might be scary, but you know what it takes, some of the prep that's involved, and this should allow you to give a good estimate of a date that you want to launch this thing and make it happen. Plug in a launch date and stick to it. Exercise 14, build your passive income ecosystem. This is massively important. The best passive income investors that I know have an ecosystem with multiple streams pouring in for them to achieve their lifestyle and their goals. So this is your opportunity to draw your spider web of things that you currently have going on, things maybe you're working on setting up, maybe income streams that you want in the future. And this is a map I like to keep visual, keep it out there. This is your opportunity to write that down and visualize what your ecosystem looks like. Exercise number 15 is simply plan for tomorrow and the future. This vision that you have, the reason you want passive income in your world is because this is bigger than you. This is a longer term vision. This is something you decided to do to change your future, your family's future, the legacy of your family. And so I simply want you to write down your 1 year goal. What does it look like in 3 years? What does it look like in 5 years? And a lot can happen in 5 years. Think of yourself 5 years ago. And then 10 year, some big thoughts. Change the decade number in front of your age right now and up it one decade. And what does that look like? Tell me what's happening in your lifestyle. What passive income do you have coming in? What are you doing with your time? And then write something simple, simple goal that you can look at and refer back to. This is you planning for tomorrow and your future. And this is crucially important. So those are 15 steps to success for you to create passive income in your world. These are steps that I've been using myself to start and continue towards completion in my passive income journey. You have the tools, you have the steps in place. Now it's time for you to take action. Hey, thanks for watching our video today. If you enjoyed it, give us a like and subscribe to our channel for upcoming content. If you want to start your journey with us, check out our community of passive income investors at our website, p25kg.com. The links are in the description below.